Holy shit, we're doing it, the motherfucking goddamn Bond-A-Thon, and we are playing 007 Everything or Nothing. I'm not gonna spoil about how much I feel about this game, but it's fucking awesome! This is the first level, Ground Zero, and we have three difficulty settings off the bat. Operative, which is core objectives only, less challenging enemies, and standard mission objectives on Agent, and then standard mission objectives and more challenging enemies. I think there's like another difficulty, I can't really remember, that adds even more mission objectives, which is always something I like about James Bond games. Oh, that looks really good. This one looks pretty good. Yeah, oh, he got me. Damn. Okay, where are we gonna be? Where are we coming in at? Tajikistan! Cool. Alright, so, the thing about Everything or Nothing is that it really fucking does not skimp out on the presentation, the story. It's just the whole fucking nine yards. We got Judi Dench there, reprising her role as M. Has surfaced in southern Tajikistan. Oh wow, this terrorist is really doing it. You know, swerve! You didn't think it was coming. So, combat in Everything or Nothing is kind of very pop-and-shoot mechanics. Not quite Gears of War. Gears of War wasn't a thing yet. But you just lock on and then shabams. It's third person, as you can clearly see, which I am not opposed to. As we've played a lot of James Bond games, they're all first-person shooters, which is fine. But I don't mind the occasional Everything or Nothing, especially since you are playing as James Bond. You kind of want to see him quite a bit. I think you might be able to tell a bit, controlling Bond actually feels pretty good. The controls are pretty tight. You got this handy fucking dive. It looks great. You can shoot guys while you're diving. Not quite Max Payne levels, but still up there. Commander Bond, we must leave now. Hurry. I'm going. There you go. Oh no, the Harrier and it's on fire! Fuck you! I can outrun explosions while carrying nuclear briefcases. Nice little like theme tribute there. Really subtle. Oh, are we going into the moon? Are we gonna go into a theme song? Yeah! Any good James Bond game, they're always kept really good track of the scores, like everything you've done in the level and how to unlock stuff. That was just the opening mission, so I just got gold, but it really, you know, facilitates playing through the game over and over again and getting that high score and unlocking some, you know, maybe multiplayer stuff, maybe some extras, you know, lots of cool crap.
Our latest in stealth munitions. Grenades disguised as coins.
Uh-huh.
One of these are your enemies to make short work of them.
So we got John Cleese just returning, like, super in form for his role as Q. It's definitely nice to have him here, although you don't see him that much in the game, but, you know, you never usually see Q when you're out, you know, boning hot babes and blowing up hot dudes. So the second level in the game is just, like, this cool virtual reality simulator, and it kind of gets around the dumb issue of Bond learning on his own job. Like, he's just going here for some extra practice, and it kind of makes sense in the context of, you know, MI6. Because remember, like, we've been playing James Bond games in first person for quite a couple of years before this. So I guess EA was like, fuck, we need to make something to, like, make people go, oh, right, third person again, because we want everyone to fucking forget, you know, tomorrow never dies. Prepare the gadget and fire. This is what I was saying before. You just walk straight up. It's actually really cool. And it looks way better than, you know, kind of using the first-person stuff in the previous Bond games that had grappling guns. I also like how these lasers are here just so I don't, like, fall back down and kill myself. It's a good bug fix that way. It's kind of lazy, but... Oh, shit! Oh, damn. Oh, God, white! Oh, like I said, I'm playing on the original Xbox, so it's hard to remember these weird buttons. So as you can see, the way that Everything or Nothing works is that I have a lock-on, but it's actually kind of soft because with the right stick, I can actually do a little precision aiming and aim for the head. If I just lock onto him, it's going to lock right onto the barricade, which is no good. So if I just move the reticule up a little bit where the guy's going to be, bams! Yeah, I'm going to exit the fucking crouch like a boss. So well before Detective Vision, you had... Bond sense. Yeah, Bond sense is a thing. It kind of just highlights things a little bit. It's not exactly, like, it's not as integral to the game as Detective Vision was in all the Batman games. I will do it. Repel off ledge by running straight out of your gadget will do arrest. Oh, holy shit. Yeah. That's fucking awesome.
To secure the doctor and destroy the nanobot prototypes.
So I gotta save Heidi Klum and I gotta destroy thousands of tiny robots. Sounds good. You know, couldn't you give yourself like 30 seconds at least? No one even saw you do that, James. Like, how would they know? Aw, James, you're so stupid. Oh my God, look how radical this is. Aw, shit, son. Yeah. So this is how the second level fucking starts. That was a goddamn slick camera angle. So you gotta rappel. You gotta rappel like a badass. So I made a pretty explosive entrance into Egypt. You know, off the bat, if I didn't already kind of say it already, this game looks pretty damn good. It holds up pretty well. This came out at the end of 2004, the start of 2005. Like I said, I'm playing on the Xbox. It runs in widescreen, and it still looks a little sharp. It's a little soft. But the models look really great. Let's get a look at James's face here, if I can. So, there's his model. He looks pretty damn good. Looks, you know, as much as Pierce Brosnan can look. Oh, these dudes are trying to rappel. Fuck you. No one can rappel like me. Alright, we got the Vanquish again. The dumb disappearing invisible car from Die Another Day. Oh, wow. Holy crap. Am I playing Disaster Day of Crisis? Damn, man.
Sir, no damage so far, sir, but I'm still checking.
I'm still checking about the damage, sir. I can't do anything about the damage. We'll never recover from this damage, sir. We keep getting caught up in MI6's rhythm. We got Jaws! Jaws is here! Poor Richard, the actor that played Jaws, unfortunately died a few months ago.
I guess not.
It's awesome that Jaws is in this. So, these are really neat because James can't really defeat Jaws. All he can do is sort of let Jaws kill himself. We'll see if we can get that done here. I gotta knock Jaws in electricity. It's a guy's with a metal mouse one weakness. James can never fucking knock out Jaws in a fucking fist fight. So, I like that you have to use those little environmental things to get that done. Alright, we beat Jaws. What the fuck could be after that? Oh my God, the doctor's actually handcuffed there. So they got Heidi Klum. Heidi Klum is not a good actress, though. Oh wow, this looks great, though. Alright, we got up and down. Whew. Just give me a second to... Alright. Triggers to go. Ascend. Descend. Alright, wow, helicopters. Oh, look at that. Look at those god rays. Looks super good. Oh, shit. Oh man, the Valley of the Pharaohs fucking crumbling beneath the weight of my British dick! What the fuck? That's super sick. I used to have one of those bases in a lake not too far from here, but I had to get rid of it for personal reasons. Ah, you need a break from all that madness.
You saved my life.
Okay, let's bone. Are we boning now? I think I can think... All right, James, start off slow.
Like that. But until then...
Here's a little kissy kiss for your James Bond face.
As a small down payment.
I look forward to collecting the rest.
Ah, that's pretty good. The only problem I really had in Nightfire is that it was a little more hokey and over the top than most games in the James Bond, but this is... Ooh, what's this?
The mission was successful.
All of the nanobots were destroyed, except for one. My
gift. Oh, the breast one.
MI6 and James Bond.
Bond.
What?
You know him?
He killed Max Zorin, my man.
Max Zorin!
I didn't know.
Holy shit. So we got Willem fucking Defoe. We got goddamn, like, Norman Osborn in this game as the main villain.
No, in fear, the name...
Nikolai Diavolo.
You'll have everything you desire.
Yes, Katya. Everything. Or nothing.
Oh, I like it. I like it. Oh, of course. Oh, fucking course. Can't beat that shit. You can't beat Pat's mom. So a little MI6, cutscene over here. As I was saying before, Max Zorn was played by Christopher Walken in one of the Roger Moore movies, which is just awesome connection to have. Christopher Walken was a villain in a James Bond movie. Does anyone realize that? You know, you gotta go watch that one. I forget which one it is, because of course there's 25 movies now. But, I mean, what would Christopher Walken have to say about that today if we were going to ask him?
Hey kids, it's me, megalomaniacal supervillain Christopher Walken. I almost killed Roger Moore once, but it didn't go so good. I was too distracted by this hot lady who was always having sex all over me. How?
So, this is a very different level than most. You actually spend most of this entire section just driving around doing mission objectives. Not just shooting things and whatever. You have to go to different locations on the map. You even have to be stealthy. Because since your car can go invisible with the power of the Q cloak, you're able to just sort of stealth your way past enemies. And you'll see where and why in a second. I'll use my Q invisible! Shabams! Fuck, what? Oh. Okay, we gotta use the cloak to avoid enemy patrols. As you can see, those orange dots on the map, I have to go in an invisible mode and just drive past them and get to my mission objective marker. And I have to go around this cool, like, little villa area. It's really in-depth for what would just be, like, oh shit. A generic driving mission becomes, like, a whole different thing. So one of the neat things about Everything or Nothing is that we can deploy our super RC car. Look how cool that is. I wish I had one of those things. We have to blow everything fucking sky high right here.
Well done, Doug.
Everything goes nuts. M didn't even give me that idea. It was all me. Jeez. What? What's going on? You know what? This is a battle I might not win. So now we're back to third person, which is great. I was kind of hankering for it after a while. We have this great little level in the mines that has a lot of, like, you know, short rappelling, hidden little spots, a lot of waist-high cover, as you can see. So the one thing about the game is that this is the way you select your weapons and all your gadgets. It's a little slower than I would like. The world is not enough. I did it a little bit faster than this, but putting on gadgets and weapons where they're their own separate buttons wasn't too complicated, and you kind of got used to it, but this menu is just a little bit slow. It pauses the entire game, so you can at least get that shit done.
First, we take over Russia. Then we unleash our little nanobots on the world.
Okay, think about that. Willem Defoe as a Bond villain. It's fucking amazing. It's one of the many reasons why I love this game. Of course, Willem Defoe. This was his video game high point, culminating in his video game low point in Beyond Two Souls. So guys, I think that about wraps up everything I have to say about Everything and Nothing. If you didn't get it before, you'll get it now. That this is one of my favorite Bond games. Maybe not the best one, but it's one of my favorites because it does the license absolute fucking justice. It was the first one to get the likenesses and all the authentic voice acting in there. It has a great Bond theme at the start. It controls well. It still looks good. I didn't go into the multiplayer mode. You can see some of it right there, but because there's no bots in it, unfortunately, so I can't even boot it up because I'm only the one guy that's here playing this game. Can't even boot it up right now, but multiplayer mode, there's some stuff in there for those that want some little extra replayability. Everything or nothing. If I've said this in previous Bond-A-Thons, if you see this in a bargain bin, you want to get a game for yourself on eBay, you will do yourself a great service, because especially if you love Bond or first person or third person shooters, it is an absolutely fantastic game. It's a little dated in some tiny aspects. The inventory is still a bit clunky. The aiming and lock-on system is a little bit weird, but you know, you have to remember this is pre-Resident Evil 4, pre-Gears of War, pre all that stuff. But you really can't go wrong, because this is still a really awesome game. It has my boy Pierce. That's my main thing. It has the lovely cardboard cutout that is Shannon Elizabeth. It's got Jaws. It's got everything you possibly want. Now, in terms of the score breakdown, everything or nothing, as an overall video game product, everything or nothing, again, just shy of perfect. 4.5 Green Goblins out of 5. But as a fucking love letter to the Bond license, to the Bond universe and everything about it, it's 5 fucking Green Goblins out of 5. There's no ifs, ands, or buts. It's probably one of the best licensed games in terms of, you know, really servicing the fans of the material. Just everything or nothing really is one of the best Bond games ever made.
Look, for more walking and gaming content, check out Game Society Pimps.